FortiOS 7 has some very cool features that were missing up until now. Let's look at some new features that I personally like. All right, so the following is not by any means the best new features or the ones that are fitting the most demanding needs from the industry, but they are the ones that actually caught my attention. So one of the very first things that you will see is that you have a new security profile, which is a video filter profile where you can restrict different YouTube channels using their channel ID. You can also restrict Vimeo video streaming using the config video filter. And here, if you use the profile, you can edit a new profile. Let's just name it Vimeo. And if you use the get, you will see that you can actually set a Vimeo restrict where you can restrict mature content. All right. The other new thing that I found is the ability to log CLI commands. I'm not sure if that was available before. I don't think so. So you will need to set the config system global and set the CLI audit log to enable. Now, once you do so, you can actually play around with different commands, get system status, and so on. And each command is actually being logged. You can move to your logs and report. Let's just move over. Events, system events, and you will see the different CLI commands that were used. This feature is, in my opinion, one of the most interesting and exciting ones. You can actually see what other admins are doing on your FortiGate up to the CLI level. Another thing in security profiles, file filter actually gets its place under or within the other sensors, within the other profiles. You can create new file filter and use it directly on your firewall policy. Let's just create one. I haven't done so. Let's name it. And here we can see that you have a new file filter and you can choose your sensor. All right, let's move to settings. In settings, you will see that you have some new features. One of them, which is the most noticeable, is the ability to use your hard disk as for local logs or for WAN optimization. Up until now, you had to use your command line and you had to do different things, but here you can actually do it directly on your graphical user interface. Remember, your hard disk is by default is meant to save logs, local logs, and here you can actually use it for WAN optimization, which is nothing new, but it wasn't available as part of the graphical user interface. Here you can also set your customization, your different teams. There's a new dark matter team, there's a new retro theme. You can play around with the different themes, which makes it a bit more interesting for users. All right, another thing is the ability to edit in CLI. So you will see that in just about every place on your FortiGate or in most places, you will also have the ability on the right side to edit the profile or the sensor directly on the CLI. So you can just right click and you will move to your command line. Another thing in security profiles is antivirus, which currently now has the new AI engine, the new machine learning engine. It actually replaced the heuristic scan. So to use it, use the config antivirus settings. And now if you use the get, you will see that you have a new machine learning detection, which by default is enabled. All right, now another thing that is quite interesting is the fact that you can, in several places on your FortiGate, you can actually right click on different objects and create a firewall policy using this object directly from the object page. So this object is now part of a firewall policy that you can configure, which makes things much more simpler. Now, when it comes to dashboards and different widgets, FortiGate actually is doing really a nice work from version to version. The widgets looks much better. They contain much more information. And the last thing that we will look at is a security fabric automation, where the creation of automation stitches now becomes much more easier.